Hello friends, welcome to NAC Graphics. Following the series of tutorials, till now we have covered this list of chapters in detail. You can access to these chapters by going to the channel's playlist. In this video, we are going to start discussing the chapter of aligning the objects. I'll try to explain this topic in detail in three videos. So let's start with it. Aligning simply means arranging the drawn objects in a disciplined way. Whenever you draw or select any object, the options related to aligning appears in the control panel. Like here I draw a rectangle, and up here the options related to aligning starts appearing. If I will deselect this rectangle, the options will be gone. So one thing should be clear to you is that the object you want to align must be selected. Alright? Illustrator also provides you a specific panel containing align options, which you can get by going to the window menu and select align. I have already docked this panel here. Now here we have three different options available. First is align objects, second is distribute objects, and last is distribute spacing. In this video, we will discuss this area in detail. Here we have six options. First three are for horizontal aligning, which are horizontal align left, horizontal align center, and horizontal align right. And next three options are for vertical aligning, which are vertical align top, vertical align center, and vertical align bottom. Before you use any of these options of aligning, Illustrator asks you that to what thing you want to align things. Illustrator gives three options here. Align to selection means that the aligning of objects will be done subject to the area covered by the selected objects. Align to key object means that the aligning of objects will be done subject to position of a particular key object. And align to artboard means that the aligning of objects will be done subject to the artboard area. Now let's run through some practical examples through which I'll explain you all the options. Here we have this circle here, and I want this to come right at the center of the artboard. So I'll select this, then make sure that align to artboard is selected here. Now Illustrator will align this shape referring to the area of the artboard. Now firstly, I'll press this button to align it in the center of horizontal line across the artboard. And now I'll press this button to align it in the center of vertical line across the artboard. And now this shape is at the center of the artboard. Coming to the next example, here I want these four squares to form a big square and then align that big square to center of the artboard. So I'm dragging and placing them together to form a big square here. Now I will select all these shapes and press this button to horizontally align center and this button to vertically align center. And here is the result. Since every object was distinct from each other, Illustrator has applied the alignment operation to each square individually. And hence, all squares got centered and got stacked over each other. I will undo this move, and to do it successfully, I will firstly group these squares by pressing Ctrl G. Now if I press horizontal align center and vertical align center, the whole group will get perfectly aligned to the center of the artboard. Right? Coming to the next example, here I want these blue squares to get aligned on the left side of the artboard and these orange squares to get aligned on the right side of the artboard. So I'll select the blue squares with black arrow and then press this horizontal align left, and here you can see they all are aligned to the left side. And likewise, I'll select these orange squares and press horizontal align right to align them on the right wall of the artboard. Similarly, I want these red colored squares to align at the top of the artboard and these yellow squares at the bottom of the artboard. For this, I will select these squares, choose vertical align top, and for these yellow squares, I'll choose vertical align bottom. Alright? So far, we have aligned objects with artboard as the reference. Now let's see how align to selection works. I have selected these yellow squares. Now if I select horizontal align left, Illustrator will see the leftmost point of the selected objects, which is this side of square, and it will align all the squares to this left line like this. Similarly, if I choose horizontal align right, Illustrator will choose the rightmost point of the selected objects and align all the squares to that point like this. And if I choose horizontal align center, Illustrator will find the center of the selection area and align the squares accordingly. You can have a view of the selection area by viewing the bounding box. Go to the view menu and select view bounding box. Illustrator assumes the selection area to be this bounding box and aligns the selected objects accordingly. So here is the center of this bounding box, and horizontal align center will align all the selected squares accordingly. I'm turning off the view of bounding box. Now let's do the same thing for these uneven rectangles. I select them all and choose horizontal align left to align all the rectangles to the leftmost point of the selection area, like this. Undo it and then horizontal align right to align all the rectangles to rightmost point of the selection area, like this. Again undo it, and then horizontal align center will align all the rectangles to the center of the selection area, like this. In the similar way, vertical aligning will work. Let's do it for these shapes. I select these red squares, and if I choose this option of vertical align top, all the squares will get aligned to the topmost point of these selected squares, which is supposed to be this. And there we have it. Applying vertical align bottom to these yellow squares will align all the squares to this bottommost point like this. And now I am selecting all these squares, and if I choose vertical align center, it will align these squares to the center of the selection area, which is supposed to be this. And there we have it. Alright. Now let's see how align to key object works. Simply put, here we will indicate a particular object and tell Illustrator to align according to the position of that shape. Here I am selecting these small rectangles along with this big red rectangle, then choose align to key object, and notice that Illustrator has selected this shape to be the key object. A key object is highlighted with a thick outline. Here if I want this big red rectangle to be the key object, I will simply click over it with black arrow tool. And now this red rectangle has become the key object. There is another way to do it. I am deselecting this selection for now and again making a selection of these rectangles. And now if I click once again over any selected shape, it will become the key object like this. Okay, now for the aligning options here. Horizontal align left will align all these small squares to the leftmost point of this key object, which is this. And here is the result. If I do horizontal align center, it will align all these squares to the center of this key object, which is this, and here is the result. And likewise, if I choose this option of horizontal align right, it will align to the rightmost point of this shape, which is this, and here is the result. Now let's finally apply these three vertical aligning options to these squares. Here I drag to select them all. Click over it again to make it key object, and vertical align top will align to the topmost point of this red rectangle like this. Vertical align center will align them to the center of this red rectangle. And finally, vertical align bottom will align all these rectangles to the bottommost point of this key object like this. Alright? So we have discussed all the options related to aligning of object with respect to artboard, selection, and key object. In the next video, we will discuss the options related to distributing objects. I hope you find this video useful. Thanks for watching NatGraphics, and do subscribe to the channel for more upcoming tutorials.